Hello everyone. I welcome you to the course Technical Communication. Today we are going to discuss lecture 14, that is about presentation skills. In the previous lecture or previous unit, because today we have started with unit 3, and in unit 2 we discussed about how to write different sort of technical writing, that is the documents. So be it technical research paper or seminar or conference paper writing, thesis writing, dissertation writing, or technical report or technical proposal. We learned how to structure them and what sort of things we should include in writing such type of papers. Now from this unit, we are going to turn towards spoken communication. That is, we are going to discuss about presentation skills. So this presentation skills will be divided into two parts. This video will be divided into two parts. In this video, I will be discussing and giving you the glimpses of presentation skills. What actually is presentation skills? What are the steps of presentation skills? What are the aids that we should involve in presentation skills? And what are the main parts of presentation skills? So let's get started. First of all, with the introduction, I would tell you that we are going to discuss about presentation skills. What is presentation skills? Then what are the different forms of oral presentations? Importance, do's and don'ts, what you should include, what you shouldn't include or avoid. Stages in developing a presentation. Main parts, body language that should be carried out during a presentation, while giving a presentation. Paralinguistic features, that is tone and voice. And finally, use of audiovisual aids. In the next video, I will discuss classroom and interpersonal communication. So first of all, presentation skills. Presentation skills are a set of abilities that enable an individual to interact with the audience, transmit the message with clarity, engage the audience in the presentation, and interpret and understand the mindsets of the listeners. Dear listeners, kindly pay attention to the words that I have highlighted in red, because these are the key words that you should again and again recall, and you can make your answer based on these keywords. So these are very important. So kindly pay attention to that. Presentation skills are a set of abilities that enable individual. What does it enable an individual to do? That is, interact with the audience. See in the picture, the man here in the black suit is interacting with his audience upright in a right posture, transmit the message with clarity. Now, whatever message you have to transmit, that should be very clear, very precise, so that your audience does not get does not remain in confusion. Engage the audience. This is the task of a presenter, that he or she has to engage his audience or her audience so that they don't get bored and the presentation does not get seems to be uninteresting. Interpret and understand the mindset of the listeners. So while presenting, you have to understand what is the mindset of their listeners. Thus, a presentation is a talk giving a group of people information about an idea, subject, or a product. Presentation is always two-way. As I told you, that presentation, whenever you are talking to somebody, interpersonal communication is giving and receiving of information. So two people are always involved. Now it could be more than two people, but minimum two people are involved with whom you are interacting and the one who is listening to you. So presentation is always a two-way communication characterized by formal and structured presentation of a message. So whenever you are giving a presentation, it is always formal, right? Informally, you do not have to give presentations. Formally, you present it, you structure it properly. The points that I'll be discussing as main parts of a presentation: introduction part, then the content part, and after that, the conclusion part. So a proper structuring is there of presentation. You also use various visual aids so that the audience gets attracted to it, and it becomes easier for the audience to understand and easier for you to explain your viewpoint or share your information with your audience. Oral presentations are purposeful. They are purposeful, interactive, formal, audience oriented, what I was already talking about. Now, both oral and written, see, it could be written as well and oral. Oral presentation is when you're standing in front of your audience and you are presenting something, you're discussing, like lectures that you attend in your classes. That is oral presentation. And written written presentation, you can include this PowerPoint presentation, could be written presentation. Here, along with presentation, you have the written content that you can refer to, that your eyes can refer to, can see, along with listening about the concept of this whole PowerPoint presentation. Play an important role in helping an organization achieve its objectives. Now, these presentations everywhere, presentation you can see everywhere, right from the classes, right from your childhood days where you used to do role plays, where you used to represent yourself, whether becoming a doctor, whether becoming a nurse, a patient, or any vegetable seller, anything. That role plays help you to enhance your speaking skills, wherein you presented right from your childhood till now. If you remember being in a kindergarten, you were being asked to recite a rhyme. That is a part of oral presentation. And your life cannot end without giving or involving in presentations. Time and again in entire life, you have to give presentations at various domains, right? So presentation skills or speaking skills is very important. One should know how to speak fluently and correctly. Now, these are certain forms of presentation where especially you as technical people or engineers or maybe professionals, let us talk about professional, let us not become specific. So if I talk about a general term, that is professionals. Being professionals, you have to handle various seminars wherein you have to attend them, as well as it could be there that you have to give or present yourself in seminars. Then conferences, workshops, student presentations, departmental presentation, industry conferences, company profile presentation, and face-to-face meeting. Face-to-face meeting is also one kind of presentation. So seminars, conference, and workshop, if I differentiate between these three, and if you get confused between these three, seminars are something which is conducted usually in one day only, and there is an expert who speaks about a particular topic that has been pre-decided what topic has to be spoken on. So seminars are shorter in length as compared to conferences, where large number of people are involved and there also experts are there who speak on a topic, but there could be subtopics of that particular topic and there could be different topics related to one main topic on which you have to, which you, by you I mean the expert, has to speak, right? So it could last for 2 to 3 days. It is a big affair as compared to seminar. Workshops is something where, in a simple terms, there is hands-on practice, that is practical sense is involved, where you learn by doing things. So workshop, seminar, and conference, there is a difference between all these three. Student presentation, you are all aware of student presentation, which you are giving since your childhood. Departmental presentations are there, interdepartmental and departmental, what achievement they have done as a department. Industry conferences are there, you must have attended or you will be attending at a later stage. Company profile presentations are there, where you have to meet your clients and you have to give your company's profile, background, and give presentations of the product and services that you are giving or providing to the people, and face-to-face meetings. Next is importance of presentation skills. Now we have understood what is presentation skills. We should also know that what is the importance of presentation skills and how does presentation be, if you are a good presenter, then how important it is for you to become a good presenter. It is important because, number one, it helps an individual to enhance his growth opportunity. If you are a good speaker, you carry yourself very well, definitely you have chances to grow well in your domain. In case of striking deals and gaining clients, it is essential for business professionals to understand the audience. So whenever you are taking a product, suppose you deal in furniture line, right? So you meet your meet various people, various clients, wherein you have to give company profile presentation, and after that about the product. If you have the capacity, if you are a good speaker, if you have the capacity to convince or persuade your client, the client is in your hand, and the money that you get will be definitely it's going to add in your for your career growth, for your success. Business professionals have to arrange seminars, conferences almost every day, right? So it increases individual's chance of success. So ye presentation skills ke through aap jitna ho sake, matlab aap jitna speaking ability ko aap increase karenge, jitna logo se acche se baat karenge, apne aap ko better present kar payenge, utne aapke chances hote hain for success, right? Next one is do's. So let us come on do's. What are the things that we should do for a good presentation or for being a good presenter, right? So number one is check what is expected of you when invited to speak. It's not that you can speak well, you are confident enough, your content, but content should have some variability. If you are standing on a stage or if you are standing in front of your audience, you should know what to speak. What is the topic of the day? What is the topic of that event where you have to speak? You cannot speak anything, right? So you have to be very specific related to your topic only. Prepare good summarized notes. So you should have always this in mind that what the topic is, and you should have that jotted points in your mind what I will speak if it is an oral presentation. Establish a clear structure. What I have to say at the starting, then in the middle, and then at the end, how will I conclude? Realize and accept that all good speakers experience certain amount of nervous tension. It is not that the people who are afraid of speaking, they are only nervous. Even a very, even a person whom you know is a very, very good speaker and can speak and address people at any time, he also has a certain kind of nervousness, but that nervousness is not that nervousness that it can hamper his ability to speak well, right? So never ever think that you don't feel nervous at all addressing the audience. Yes, you do, but it should not overpower your speaking ability. Plan and rehearse beginning with care. So introductory part should be very, very impressive. As you know, first impression is the last impression. If you establish the initial first 3 minutes, 5 minutes, let's suppose, if you grab the attention of your audience for 5 minutes, you can think that the audience is yours. It is in your hand. So prepare the content, introductory part, that way that people listen to you. The people here, they're bounded to hear to. Put pace and enthusiasm into your delivery. It should not be monotonous. It should not be dull. It shouldn't be boring. If I say you can put pace and enthusiasm into the delivery, ensure you are clearly audible, maintain good eye contact. How the monotony that I'm building, one cannot understand the way it should have been understood. Right? So when you see what is the pace, am I going too fast? Am I going too slow? Or enthusiasm, that energy should, zeal should be there while presenting. So the delivery part, which I have already discussed with you, like nuances of delivery, it could be memorized way, it could be manuscript way, it could be extemporaneous. So there could be different ways to deliver, but it should be with good zeal and enthusiasm. Ensure you are clearly audible. Now check your mic and everything, settings, everything before presenting, because you should be clearly audible. Otherwise, if you're not audible, who is interested in listening to you? Nobody. So you should be clearly audible. In fact, you should double check your audience whether they are able to hear you or not. You should always maintain good eye contact. That is a very essential part of presentation. Maintain proper body posture. Body posture should not be lean, should not be laid back or like a sloth. It should be proper, like you should be standing erect, straight, and should be giving with proper gestures. Plan and rehearse conclusion. Now, the introductory part and the conclusion part. both should be too good. So if you are representing yourself, whatever presentation you are giving, if your introductory part is good, if your concluding part is good, you bid the. Next is don't. What things you should avoid? Avoiding preparing too much material. Check your timing. You should always adhere to your time. Time management should be there. If you have been given 15 minutes, your content should be contained or should be included in that 15 minutes. It should not, you should not sway from your topic or should include extra time. Always be specific to time. Try to do with speaker's note. As I told you, जो आपके नोट्स होते हैं, so keeping your notes along with you, referring to them again and again, no, prepare well, rehearse well, so that you do not have to refer to your notes. It should be there in your mind, jotted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is what I'm going to talk about. Read the script verbatim, that is reading anything verbatim. You're reading, today I am going to speak on the topic this, no, it should be with eye contact. See, it is very difficult if you do a manuscript way, because then you are only looking at your paper instead of looking into the eyes of your audience and building that rapport with the audience, right? Cracking weak or dodgy jokes. So there is no point of cracking those weak, dodgy, unusual jokes that should not be a part of a presentation. Definitely, you can add humor, but that doesn't mean that lame jokes should be called on. Split your audience attention by misuse of aids or handouts. So you should avoid splitting your audience attention, totally looking into the aids, that is audiovisual aids that you're using. They should be appropriate, should be related to the content or handouts, right? So rock, sway, or use repetitive gesture. Rock means swaying from here and there, rocking, traveling, walking, coming back, or rock means patthar ki tarah khada ho jana, ekdam still. You have to move a bit, you have to move your hands, but in a proper way, as it is required. Then again, giving same gestures. You should change some. Sometimes you have to frown your eyes, sometimes you have to give a smile, sometimes you have to be show nervousness, or you have to move your hands, shrug your shoulders, but not too much. So depending on what your content is, what the situation is in which you are talking, you have to use appropriate gestures, right? Rush, be in a hurry. No. If you know you have 20 minutes, utilize your 20 minutes in a good way. Do not show koi jaldi ho rahi hai aapko ki you have to go. No. If 20 minutes are given to you, you should be involving audience. You should not think of anything else. Assume hostility. Hostility is a negative word, which means kisi ke towards jealousy rakhna ya kisi ke taraf ghrina rakhna. So you should not assume hostility with anyone. Next comes stages of developing a presentation. So stages of developing a presentation, you have to plan first. Whenever a topic is being given to you, you plan what topic I'm going to speak, or maybe it has been given to you, or maybe you are thinking of your own that I'll be giving presentation on so and so topic. So planning is the first and foremost part, where you define the purpose of presentation, ki kyun aap karna chahte hain presentation, dena kya chahte hain, kaun sa topic hai. Analyzing the audience, you analyze the audience, their age, gender, and background, and various other things on which your presentation will be developed. And determine the timing. As I said, time management is very important while presenting yourself, and method of delivery, the way you are going to present yourself. Then you organize that material, collect it from different places, you refer to different sources, you arrange the data in a logical manner. Then you put some visual aids. You select some appropriate number and content of visual aids, what you are going to include. Then you practice, you rehearse time and again, so that on the day of presentation, you are the perfect. Delivery, dress properly. Now, dressing properly is very important. Appearance, physical appearance in a presentation is very, very important. Maintain friendly eye contact. Speak in an effective manner and answer questions confidently. The questions that are being asked by the audience, you should answer it confidently. So you should have that kind of grip over your content that whenever you are speaking on whatever topic you are speaking on, the audience, if ask you any question, you are well prepared to answer. And if you are you have that grip over your content, you will be so confident to answer any sort of question that is being asked to you by your audience. Now, what are the main parts of a presentation? Through this diagram, I'm trying to make you understand, like in a hamburger, the upper portion is, the top bun is introduction. Now, at the back of the mind, keep presentation in your mind. And eyes say aap burger ko dekh rahe ho, mind mein aap presentation rakho. So correlate those. So the top bun is introduction. That is the first part is introduction. Introduction introduces the topic. Kya topic mein we are going to discuss. You get grab the attention of your audience. You see the background or tell the background or three main ideas, some main ideas regarding the presentation. Then the body part where all the content comes. So here, supporting statements of what you have introduced should be there. So it contains information as well as details, the data that you are talking about. And finally, the conclusion, the last one, the bottom bun, as it is conclusion, same way you have to tell about your conclusion. And that could be telling the repeating those ideas, then what was the significance of the presentation, and clincher, that is the main jise kehte na punchline hona. So they, that way you have to present your presentation. So here again I have in a diagram told you introduction, body and conclusion part. So let us now one by one do this, where you are going to tell about what introduction, where you're going to tell about what introduction, what should be included in introduction, what should be included in body part and conclusion. If I talk about introduction, attention of audience, it must capture attention of audience, hence the statement, a question can be there, it could be simple statement, a story, or refer to some interesting data. You should win audience confidence. Good introduction builds up credibility. Aapka reputation banata hai audience mein. A good way to do so is by introducing, giving the speaker's qualification or referring to organization he has worked. And third is previewing the presentation. Give the audience a preview of what is going to be presented to keep them attentive and alert. Next. The body, main content. The main content should be clear and hold attention. It can be organized in the following manner: inductive, deductive, question to answer, chronological, cause and effect. These all you know. Cause and effect, explain the cause and then effect of the situation. While using this method, speaker uses words like therefore, so, because, however, or finally. Now, Concluding part, at least 10% of the total part should be given or devoted to ending. When developing your conclusion, you should use the word like in conclusion also to sum up all. I would like to say this way, restate your main point. Your main points that you have to again repeat them. Make final words memorable with a quote, a call to action, or some encouraging words, motivating words. Do not introduce any new idea at this stage. Now, this is not the right stage to tell anything which was left to tell here. No, a big no. No new concept should be told in conclusion. Whatever you have spoken about in, let's say, past 15 minutes, past 20 minutes, past 1 hour, past 30 minutes, whatever, you have to just conclude those part. Nothing new, no new information. Now we should know what kind of body language we should adopt during presentation. We should have a soft smile, right? We should always make eye contact. We should not lock our arms. We should not knees lock nahi hona chahiye. Head up hona, chin up hona chahiye. Do not move so much. little bit movement is definitely required, but not move too much so that people only keep looking at your body or the changes that you're making through your body. Connect with the audience. You have to connect with the audience through your body language. Breathe and relax. You do not have to say everything in one breath and then no. It should be proper. Take pauses. There is no harm in taking pauses. Take pauses, take proper breath and relax. Paralinguistic features. Now, paralinguistics is tone and voice. What kind of modulation you do while speaking? Keep moderate pitch, neither too high nor too low. Shrieking nahi honi chahiye, kaan ko chupne wali. Or else itni soft bhi nahi honi chahiye that people are not able to understand or get you. Neither be too fast in pace. Aapka pace bahut fast nahi hona chahiye, bahut slow nahi hona chahiye. Clarity in speech, include variation in delivery. Emphasize or stress important points. Tone should not be monotonous. Don't shout for anything. There should be pause at right time and at right place. Practice deep breathing for making the voice louder and relaxing the mind. Now, very important thing, whatever I have discussed, either the main parts or body language, paralinguistic, or now use of audiovisual aids, these are all a part of questions that you are going to get in your exams. Visual aids help the speaker to create interest in the audience and grab their attention. Jaise ki maps, pictures, charts, overhead projectors, and blackboard. Following things should be considered while use visual aids with related topic. Show visual aids only when required. Help the audience understand the visual aid and its data for that topic. Emphasize on important points only. Do not put so much information in visual aids because content, written part is there where you can include. Then selecting the type of visual aid. Kis tarah ka visual aid you select? Select the visual aid as per the message or topic needs a different type of visual aid. Cost and time also should be kept in mind while selecting a visual aid. Too much costly or time taken should not be spent while collecting information and making the visual aid. Also, audience size should be considered. What kind of audience you are going to address, how much audience you are going to address, whether this visual aid is going to help that audience or not, or it may create hindrance in the presentation. Different types of audiovisual aids could be, it could be posters, it could be blackboard or whiteboard. You can make use of blackboard or whiteboard. Then OHP, overhead projectors, they are something where you keep the slides and then the projection is shown on the white screen. Flip charts are there. You pull it down and then you write and then you change the, you flip away the next thing. Slide projectors is there. Usually you must have seen movies dikhane ke time pe ya screening dikhane ke, you flip that, you slide the projectors, next slide lagate hain and then it comes. PowerPoint presentation, a very common way of today's world, right? PowerPoint presentation. So this was all about presentation skills. I hope you have enjoyed, rather than just understanding it, enjoyed what presentation skills, got motivated to speak, to increase that ability to speak well, and learned various things regarding giving a good presentation. So in the next video, in the next lecture, I will be covering with certain topics related to presentation skills. And those are classroom presentation or interpersonal communication and things like that in next video. Later on in the next lectures, in particular unit three, since unit three is all about presentation skills, so we'll be talking about different modes of presentation, different methods of presentation, nuances of delivery and competence, right? So thank you for the day. Keep learning and have a nice day.